What's up, SPN family? I'm Steph with Creation, and welcome to our super celebration of virtual experiences featuring the cast of Supernatural. Just a reminder that the top five tippers win a 10-minute meet and greet with Jensen right after this panel is over. So make sure your top supporter information is updated with your current email address. To do that, under the stage at screen, you'll see where it says top supporter information. Scroll to the link that says complete your top supporter information. And if you'd like to tip, click the green tip button on the bottom left-hand corner of your stage at screen. All right, today's guest needs no introduction, so I'm gonna get right to it. Please welcome the one and only Jensen Ackles.
That's what I do in the morning. It's usually my morning routine. Waking up, looking in the mirror, pretending there's an audience of one, because that's how we're living these days. What's up, everybody? Happy Sunday around the world. I know we've got people calling in or clicking in or whatever you call this from all over. So thank you for getting up early, staying up late, or turning off a game that I'm sure you're probably wanting to watch. I have my games set up right here on my iPad, so if I look this way, I'm just trying to keep up with the times. I'm super stoked to be here. I brought a friend. She didn't talk much, but sure looks good, doesn't she? Huh? Hey, what? I know. Yeah, we're just going to do a little. You good? You need makeup? No? Happy? Okay, all right. Probably needs an oil change. Anyway, happy to be here, guys. Thank you. Thank you for showing up. I really can't wait to see you all in person someday soon, hopefully sooner than later. I definitely miss that interaction and that connection and that and those smiling faces. So anyway, this will have to do, and let's get after it. I know we've come a long way as far as when we last saw each other, or if we have ever seen each other, in discussing what has recently aired. Now, for some of you, maybe you haven't seen, or maybe you haven't caught up, maybe you're not up to speed with what is played out there, what is aired out there. But I know that for most of you, we are all caught up with episode 15-19, which just aired a few days ago. I just saw it as well, the final cut, a couple of days ago, and I was happy. I thought we looked pretty great getting our asses kicked by God. But that was a fun day of filming, and I thought Rob did a fantastic job, and all around, Jake being there, and Alex, Jared, and the whole gang. So that was a lot of fun. We only have one more episode left. What could possibly happen? We've knocked off God, knocked off Billy. Death is gone. Lucifer's gone. Michael's gone. Who's left? It's just us. But that's what one more episode is here to tell you. So I can't wait to see what you guys think of that next episode. That's going to be a big one. And wraps the whole series up. And that's it. No more, no mas, until they call and say, hey, can we get that car back? And then I'll say, ha ha, no. Anyway, let's take some questions. I know we've got limited time, and there's an unlimited amount of questions here. So I'm just going to start right off the bat with looks like a Nikki MB. Hey, Nikki MB, you're out there. Nikki says, if Sam and Dean had been asked to assist on a case outside of the U.S., where would they have done it? And would you have liked Where would you have liked to film? Well, I think that Sam and Dean, they haven't gone outside the U.S. Very often. If at, no, I know they went to Scotland that one time, but I don't know that they've been too far out of the continental U.S. And that is largely in part because we couldn't take the show there just from budgetary standpoint. And so the writers are very smart. The very beginning of the show, I don't know if you remember a little episode called Phantom Traveler. Dean is a terrible flyer. So the idea of getting in a plane and flying for hours upon hours, I don't think was something that that Sam would have ever been able to talk Dean into, which is another reason why they kept driving this sucker around. It made life a heck of a lot easier for Dean. And they were also able to bring the kind of things that they would need to fight whatever they were fighting. I'm not sure that the airport security would allow the stuff that's in that trunk through the conveyor belt. That would have been an interesting episode, though. And would I have liked to film it? Yeah, I would have. Where would we have liked to film it? Anywhere. I think just going somewhere would have been great. There's a lot of great stories and folklore in many different countries out there. I mean, you could just throw a dart and start packing, but packing all that stuff, that might have been a funny episode. I would have liked that one. All right, moving on. Mary J. Hi, Jensen. My question is, can you please tell us about your new project with Daniil? Love you guys infinitely. Thank you, Mary J. Yeah, so Daniil and I have a new production company under the Warner Brothers studio umbrella. They have graciously asked us to form a company and start finding projects that speak to us, that we really like, and that we want to produce into TV shows for broadcast television, streaming platforms, you name it. We've been taking a lot of meetings, talking to a lot of producers, a lot of directors, a lot of writers, even actors. And we've got a couple of projects that we're working on right now. Obviously, with the virus and COVID and everything, that has slowed our industry down to a crawl. So things aren't moving real fast as far as the industry goes, but things are still moving, and we've got some ideas, and we've got some people working on ideas, and hopefully those ideas come to light and I can share them with all of you. When they do, I will, and I hope you'll follow me there. So that's what's up with that. Let's talk to, now I'm just going to pronounce it, but it looks like Mlikmz. Did I say that right? Did I get that right? Mlikmz. I hope that's an acronym. It says, what has supernatural taught you during these 15 years? Well, how to keep a car older than I am running. That's one thing, because she's pretty old. You know, I had this conversation and had this question with another group of folks, and I would say that there's probably not a lot in my life that I've learned and has shaped me more than my experience over the past 15 years. It's been something that I never imagined in the best way possible. And it has given me lifelong friends, and it has given me lifelong lessons that I'm will be forever grateful. And to try and list a few, we would be here all afternoon. So just say that, yes, it has changed me indefinitely. So all right, moving right along here. Anna Marie Fs. It's Anna Marie FSS. Here we go. She says, hey, I'm Anna from Brazil. What's your favorite song at the moment? Love you. Obrigado. Thank you, Anna. Favorite song at the moment. Ooh. You know, I listen to a lot of music when I was filming and traveling, and I haven't been doing that a lot lately. It's been a lot of Disney movies with the kids, and a lot of pop music dancing around in the living room. I try to throw on a Zeppelin record. I try to throw on some Allman Brothers, and it usually results in three screaming children wanting to hear somebody I don't listen to. So, but I don't know. Let's see. I'm going to go into my little iPhone here, look and see what the last song that I had downloaded would be. No kidding. It's, I don't know if you see that. Yeah. Soldier Boy, Elvis. There you go. Moving right along. Let's see. We've got Jewel Winchester. J-U-H-O Winchester. All right. Hi, Jensen. I'm Juana. Ah, from Brazil. What was the funniest situation when you got lost in the role of Dean? Example, I woke up to hunt monsters. Funny situation. There were a lot of funny situations when it came to playing Dean or to being Dean on screen. Every day was kind of a funny situation. I don't think there was any situations that followed me home, if that's kind of what you're asking. If I dealt with personal situations that were like Dean, none really that were like of the supernatural world. I think if anything, it's just been since I've had baby home, just making sure that, that engine turns over and that the muffler's not knocking and that those doors stay squeaking the way they are. That's important to me. So, all right, let's see. Moving on to Stephanie Aylman. Stephanie Aylman, she says, if you had the chance to do another crossover episode, which show would you want to be with and why? Can be live action or animated. The only crossover episode we ever did was with Scooby-Doo. I know there was a lot of talk of doing a crossover episode with some of the other shows that were on the CW that had kind of a similar theme as Supernatural, or at least dealt with certain kinds of beings that we dealt with on Supernatural, but that never really happened, largely because of just a logistical nightmare. Another show. I mean, look, I think it would always be fun to cross over with The Walking Dead. That ship may have sailed. And I think it would have been fun to cross over with what's another episode? What's another show? I always thought we should have been with Vampire Diaries and should have helped send that show off into the sunset. And I don't know, maybe they can find a way to bring us back to the last few episodes of Walking Dead. All right. Soul, the B-Day girl. Any movie, series, or book to recommend us that you discovered in quarantine? In Argentina, we continue in isolation. Well, thank you, Argentina, because I have continued in isolation myself, unlike a lot of Americans who feel that there's some sort of political angle to a virus. I don't see how that could have been a worldwide conspiracy. So I am trying to follow the science and the data as much as possible. And me and my family have been locked down basically since March. It's not easy. And to be honest, movies, TV shows, I've tried to finish shows that I started a while back and then just never had the time. So let's see, what did I'm just motoring through The Haunting of Hill House. I finished up, obviously, The Boys season two. Knocked that out pretty quick. Movie wise, haven't been to the movies in a while. And usually the movies that I watch are you know, generally kid friendly. I'll give you a kid friendly movie that I actually rather enjoyed. The Willoughbys. Thought that was pretty cool. That's all I can help you with. Moving along, we got Cal T Mann. Sure. If you could go back to season one, what would you tell yourself? Also, thanks for the last 15 years. Well, thank you for watching. Thanks for chiming in. And if I could go back to season one, what would I tell myself? That's a good question. Don't eat so much on camera, because they're going to do that to you for the next 15 years. That was kind of on me. I probably should have paced myself a little bit more with Dean's eating habits. But, at the end of the day, I think it made for some good TV. So I'm not overly upset about that one. 15, I mean, look, season one, I think I would go back and tell myself exactly what I did tell myself in season one, which was just keep your head down and do the work. And don't try to focus on, if the show is going to continue, or if the show is getting good reviews, or what the critics are saying. Keep your head down, do the work. It's a good story. It's a good character. The fans are going to find it. So just keep motoring. And that's what I did. And here we are 15 years later. So I think I'd probably go back and just say that to myself, maybe a little bit more eloquently. There we go. Moving along. Samira Winchest. All right. Another family member here. She says, hi, Jensen. I live in Iran. I'm so excited to see you. My question is, can you tell us about Soldier Boy and give us some information? Sure. So Soldier Boy, new character on The Boys that I will start playing in the new year. And one of the reasons why I've got this happening, I was asked to grow it out and we'll see what happens. So, it's getting to the point where I don't know if I can handle it, but, maybe they're just doing that as like a hazing thing for the new guy, but, I'm going to feel like Misha. I'm going to be the new guy coming in season three. He came in season four, but still, it's going to be weird. I'm about to call him and ask him, like, what did you do? Tell me exactly what you did, because I don't want to do that. That's probably how that conversation will go. And then what else was, So information, Soldier Boy, he was the original superhero in this particular world of superheroes. And if you're familiar with the show, you know that the superheroes in this particular show are not the most model citizens. They have their issues, and that is really what this show explores. And so I'm sure that I'll be dealing with a lot of really messed up issues with Soldier Boy. What those are, I have yet to see or read. I got my first script actually yesterday, and it was just kind of a basic introduction of the character. So it hasn't really peeled back layers just yet to where I get a good understanding of who he is. But I will, I'll be doing that in the next few weeks, in the next coming months, trying to really dial in who this guy is and how messed up he is. So, all right, let's see. To Sid Stojov. I could be pronouncing that right. I'm gonna ask your question here. It says, who's been your favorite big bad on the show? Ooh, favorite big bet. We've had a lot of really, really good ones. I don't have a favorite. I'm going to put it out there because I've got too many favorites. I mean, you could go down the list of Chuck and Billy and Amara and, you know, it's there's again, the Crowley and the list goes on and on and on. I will say that there's one. I'll just pick one today. Let's go with Mark Pellegrino's Lucifer. I did often find myself doing scenes with him and forgetting my lines because I was watching his performance. And that's I think that's just a testament to Mark and how much fun he had playing that character. So definitely one of my tops. Okay, DLM Johnson, when you have a creative block, what's your go-to activity to work through it? Ooh. Get up, walk around. Get up, walk around. I know that like this is something that I run into quite often when I'm directing. Because it's I like to say that the script is basically a problem. It's like a you know, think of it as like a math problem, and it's up to the director to solve it. How are we going to take what's on the page and make it visual on camera? And so you have to kind of solve those problems on your own, and then you have to tell the people what you need and the tools that you need in order to create the solution. So in the problem solving process of directing, I certainly would run into kind of a lot of that creative block of like, you know, what do I want to see here? How do I want to see it? How could I make that, you know, the best shot? How could I make it efficient? And I would just a lot of times have to get up and walk around and pace. And if it just wasn't coming to me, then I just put it down and I'd walk away from it. And I'd go watch the TV for a little while, or I'd flip on a record. And I'd you know, cook myself something or whatever. I think you just gotta get your mind off of situations. And generally, as soon as you stop thinking about what you're trying to figure out, the solution presents itself. So there you go. Thea loves you. That's your handle. Thea loves you. I love that, because then you're just giving out love to everybody. It's just, hey, it's Thea loves you. I like that. That's cool. All right, Thea. With the exemption of original Dean, which version of Dean has been your favorite to play? Sending love from the Philippines. Well, sending love right back. Favorite Dean. There wasn't a whole lot of variations with Dean. Sam got to play quite a lot of different varieties of Sam, and he also got to play a lot of different I'd say character, or at least more characters than Dean ever did. But I'd say one of my most enjoyable kind of versions of Dean was the Dean that we found in Purgatory. Now I know that's still kind of the same Dean, it's just he's in a different situation, but it was a version of him that was outside of what we normally see. And so I'd probably say the Purgatory Dean. Yeah. All right. SPN made me. Your handle is SPN made me cry. So sorry about that. Wasn't always our intention, but sometimes it was. So your question is, how many flannels do you own? Well, personally, enough. Dean, too many. It's really, I just own this one. Through the computer, I'm able to change the color combo. So today I felt black and gray. Tomorrow, I don't know, maybe green and blue. But that's, yeah, I've actually had that question before. How many flannels do you own? And my answer is enough. There we go. Next one, G-Wiz. Jensen, how are you doing? Is it a big adjustment to have SPN over? Do you think the long COVID delay has helped or hindered that process? Well, G-Wiz, I'm doing all right. I'm doing all right. You know, I'd sure love to get back to a lot of the things that we aren't really able to do right now. And I'm excited when that day comes. But until then, it's just been, you know, you try to make the most of what your situation is. And I think that if you got some good people in your life, you got a good head on your shoulders, and you can try to figure things out and keep yourself busy, keep yourself entertained. So I've been trying to do just that. And I've got three young kids that keep me pretty occupied. So, but yeah, no, we're doing good. We're doing good. And, I think that, that the COVID situation, has certainly, as far as it relates to Supernatural, I would almost say that it has, softened the blow of it being over. And that's because had the show ended and everything was normal. And, I think it would have been a much more, acute kind of situation. Because everything would have been the same, but this one big, huge part of my life would have been gone. The fact that COVID happened, it was like the whole world changed for everybody. And so I kind of feel like we're all in this together. You know, not everybody's life just kept on going perfectly normal, and then mine changed drastically. Everyone has changed. So I kind of feel like it's taken the sting out of Supernatural being over COVID. And I'm not, you know, obviously I wish that COVID was gone and I wish it would go away. But as of right now, I guess the silver lining for me personally is that it is certainly taken the dramatics out of Supernatural being over, more so than I thought, you know, had things been normal. So there you go. All right. Lorena Minotto. Hi, Jensen. Which actors did you get inspired at the beginning of your career? I mean, it was more actors that I had probably grown up watching that were influential for me without me even knowing it. You know, like Harrison Ford, Bruce Willis, Kevin Costner, you know, as far as like those action adventure guys. And then, you know, and then you go into looking at from a comedy standpoint, you know, I grew up watching the Pink Panther movies. I grew up watching Jerry Lewis movies. You know, I think there's a lot of performances and certainly actors' careers that have inspired me, or at least helped shape me, just from exposure to them at a young age. Those are kinds of some of the lessons, or the unintentional lessons that I learned early on, that I lean on quite a bit as I navigate through this career of mine, because I never had formal training as far as acting or scene study or character study or anything like that. So my acting study and scene study, character study has just been real life and watching other people perform.
All right. Gailed it. Your question, what was the final day on set like? Did you and Jared do anything to celebrate? By the way, I see the comments happening here, but I can't read that fast. So I would love to respond. No, I can't even read the usernames. So I'm just going to say thanks for all of that. Okay, so Gailed it. What was the final day on set like? Did you and Jared do anything to celebrate? Yes, we celebrated with a very, very old bottle of scotch. Because what else do you do? And the final day, it was interesting, and we'll probably unpack this over the next 15 years of just what it was like going into that final week, what it was like the final episode. The final day specifically was it was not as tearfully emotional as I had thought it might be. Instead, there was like, it was more kind of tears of joy, so to speak. And I kind of shared that with Jared early on. I said, look, man, I'm emotional, but it's not this kind of like, mournful emotion. It's not like we're losing something or we're putting something to rest. To me, it felt more of a celebration of what we had done. It was more of a reflection of this 15-year journey that we had taken and kind of taking a pause and reflecting on that and trying to look back and see just how far we've come and look at this family that has been built and we got to be a part of that. And that was a special moment. And we kind of took a moment to ourselves, just the two of us. And you'll see this in the next episode. But we took a moment in this beautiful setting and just kind of thanked each other for sharing that journey with each other. And that was a pretty special moment. That was pretty cool. Something I'll never forget. CLA underscore. Okay. Is there any habit, expression, saying, or gesture you've picked up from Dean? No, but there's a ton that Dean picked up from me. Moni Valeska, 87. Hi, I'm Moni. Let's go with Moni. Sorry if that's wrong. Apologize. I'm nervous. Me too. Would you ever get a tattoo in memory of Dean? Yeah, I would. I actually talked about it. Maybe not necessarily of Dean specifically, but the show. I know there's a few of the crew that went out and got one that we'd all talked about getting together, and then COVID kind of made it a little difficult to do that. But I might still do that. I might still get that one. So I'll let you know. AL002. Hi Jensen, I'm Alex from Mexico. Okay, so ALE, not or A. Ali O2. I'm Alex from Mexico. My question is, which is your favorite creature from the show? I love you. Thank you, Alex. Sending love right down there to Mexico. Favorite creature from the show? Ooh.
I don't know. It's, I mean, there's been so many really good ones and even ones that, that I got to direct. You know, there was, I guess I got to say that me personally, I always like playing Dean going into a vampire nest because I kind of feel like it's just, it's, he understands it the most. He knows how to battle these things. And he has fun doing it. I think he truly enjoys that kind of a hunt. So that's, yeah, I'll go with the easy answer, and that's vampire. Sarah Mora, hello from Dallas, Texas. Hey, hey, Big D. What do you think Dean would do if he had to quarantine? Much love, Jensen. Much love, Jensen. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Sarah. If Dean had to quarantine, Sam would probably have to tie a chain around his leg and anchor it to the floor. I don't know that he would want to, I don't know that he'd want to stay on lockdown for too long, but if he was forced to, I think there would be a lot of R-rated movies. I think there would be a lot of, heartburn from a terrible diet. And I think there would be, a lot of really, dirty laundry and dirty dishes. I think when you're motivated to get out and work and do stuff and hunt, I think these guys, they keep their lives together doing just that. I think if you take that away from them, much like I think a lot of us are probably experiencing right now, then it seems like a lot of those normal life activities kind of fall by the wayside, because it's like, well, if I don't have to do this, then I'm not going to do this. And then all of a sudden you just, you know, you feel like crap. So I think it is important. This is kind of steering away from a Dean answer, but I think it's important to kind of try to keep yourself motivated to do whatever you can. And so that those things don't build up and don't start to accumulate. But for Dean, I think he would certainly be the first to let it all build up and to procrastinate. And I don't know, maybe he'd go work on the car. Maybe that would keep him motivated. That'd be a fun episode, though. Karina Zhu. Hi, Jensen. When are you planning to release the album Radio Company 2.0? That's a great question, Karina. And I wish I had an answer for you for that. We haven't quite finished it yet. We were almost done. And then a lot of things happened. COVID obviously was the big kind of culprit, but we've had a series of kind of unfortunate incidences that have put it, you know, not on the back burner, but has procrastinated it. So we're still trying to get it together. We don't owe that much on it. It should be, we were hoping to have it done by the end of the year. That's still a possibility, but things would have to come together pretty quickly. So it may be more like springtime, if I'm being honest with myself. So there you go. Fiera, what would be your dream project to produce? My dream project to produce. It's not star in, not be in, just produce it. Probably be some sort of a spinoff of Supernatural, if that existed. Because I know it so well. And I get all the people together who I already know. And I think it would just be fun because it's a world that I understand so well. But then I could, you know, navigate it from a different perspective. And I think that would be really like a dream job. So I'll go with that. But we've tried it twice and it hasn't worked out, so I don't know. Okay, moving on. Giordana Marie, What was the strangest thing seen you had to do as Dean Winchester? Love you, Jensen. Brazil loves you. Well, thank you, Jordana Marie. Maria, strangest thing, Dean, I mean, look, a lot of the weird stuff that occurred on Supernatural, if it was going to occur to one of the main characters, it usually happened to Dean. So I was on the receiving end of a lot of the weird stuff, whether it was eating too much gross stuff, or whether it was blood, or whether it was goo, or whether it was I don't know. This has just been so much over the years. Like, nothing really surprised me anymore. It was like a constant onslaught of weird stuff being thrown at me. And I'm trying to think if there was just a really weird scene. I mean, there's so many weird scenes. I don't know that one stands out among the rest, though. There's just a laundry list of weird things. You know, the one recent where I ran in with the pajama gown on, I just remember looking at myself in the mirror on my way to set and thinking, what am I doing with my life? Yeah, there's not many times you look at yourself and ask that when you're actually gainfully employed and working at a job you love. So there was that. Okay. Sam Winchester's hair. Oh, yes, Sam Winchester's hair. What is your question? Hi, Jensen. The name's Ollie. Ah. Why did it take you so long to introduce yourself? Ollie, what's one food typically considered weird that you actually enjoy? Okay, first, Sam Winchester's hair. It's really nice. It's nice to have a name. And I can't tell you, Ollie, how many times I've threatened to cut you off. You know, maybe a snip here, a snip here, maybe just a quick buzz. And then just Ollie falls to the ground. It is really nice to have a name, though. You know, I guess now I know what to call you. And I'll just call you Ollie. And then Jared will look at me weird, or Sam will look at me weird, and I'll just point up and just be like, we know each other. We've been introduced properly. Ollie, food typically considered weird that I actually enjoy. I don't know. Because see, like, maybe I don't consider it weird. Maybe other people don't consider it weird. Something weird. I mean, look, I didn't have fish until I was like 18 years old, because I grew up in Texas, and for some reason there was this mentality growing up. And it's like, I know freezer trucks existed when I was growing up, but it was like, oh, you don't want to eat fish if you don't live near a body of water. So, you know, my gauge on what's weird has been skewed since I was a kid. But what do I eat that's weird? I don't know. I make myself a fried egg sandwich just about every other day, and my wife thinks that's weird. Maybe it's just how often I do it, but that's, I enjoy it. So we'll go with that. All right. But again, Ollie, it's really nice to finally get a name there, pal. It's been, I feel like I've known you forever. Bia Dominelli.
Hi, Jensen. If you had never gotten a role in Supernatural, do you think you'd have watched it? In that case, Dean would still be your favorite character. Would Dean still be your favorite character? Yes and yes. There's a reason that I did the show so long, and it's because I really liked the show. There's a reason that I liked playing Dean Winchester as long as I have, and it's because I really like that character. So, yeah, I think I would have watched it, and I would have wanted to see a character like what I did with Dean or whoever. If he was being portrayed similarly to the way I did it, then yeah, I would have liked to have seen that. I think I would have enjoyed it. So, Murmur, did any script change because of COVID? Yeah, we had to, not drastically by any means. We had to make some tweaks, due to protocol. Due to certain protocol, we had to change up some locations, and we also lost the ability to do a couple of scenes just because of logistics involved that related to COVID. But none of it really changed the outcome of the story. And once all is said and done, once the show has finished and aired its last, I'm sure we will share all of those tweaks. But until then, I don't want to ruin anything. So, all right, Jake and Bake fan, why did it take you so long to help Jared lift the log for Brave Alecky? Well, I will say that what you saw in the video was just a small portion of the whole crew, including myself, watching Jared try to lift a variety of logs for a solid half an hour. So entertainment is why. Kelly. Hi, Kelly. Hi, Jensen. I am from BC, British Columbia. Nice. I'm wondering what your favorite thing about filming in British Columbia was. Love you. Thank you, Kelly. Love you. I'll tell you one thing. The people of British Columbia, Canada, are fantastic. I have made some lifelong friends up there, and I certainly hope to come back sooner than later. I know I will. For whatever reason, but I often said that my only complaint with Vancouver and being up in that part of the world was that it wasn't home, but it was certainly the best home away from home I could have hoped for. People were fantastic. The scenery, I mean, there's a reason that the slogan of British Columbia is supernatural. And it's not because of our show. It is a supernaturally beautiful part of the world. And if you, for those folks out there who have never been to British Columbia or to Vancouver specifically, I certainly hope you get to go there and see that beautiful city. And if you're a fan of Supernatural, then you might see a lot of things you recognize because we were there for 15 years. So thanks, Kelly. Sammy in the Sky. Hi, bonjour from France. Bonjour. Would you ever do some more voice acting work? I miss your Jason Todd so much. Yes, Sammy in the Sky. I would, and I have, and some of that work should be coming out relatively soon. I think maybe in the next 6 months. But I have been working, doing some voice stuff in that genre of storytelling, and I've actually done a few things while we've been on COVID quarantine stuff. So luckily I got a big mic here that helps me with that.
So, yeah, Sammy, I do like to do the voice work, and we'll continue to do it as long as they continue to ask me. All right, CRS, CHRSNUNES. Is that Chris Nunes, maybe? I'm sure. Yeah, it is. Hey, I'm Chris. What's your favorite episode that you directed? Love from Brazil. A lot of love from Brazil. It's awesome. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Chris. Favorite episode I directed? I mean, look, they all kind of had their own beautiful twists and had all their own beautiful challenges. I would say that my favorite one was probably my first one, and it was simply because I wasn't in it that much, and I was able to just focus on directing. And Jim Beaver was kind of the main character of that particular episode, and so I got to, I got to work with just a seasoned pro, and thankfully it was Jim, because he helped me kind of do the best I could from behind the camera. So that was one of my favorite experiences, and then they all just kind of like got in line right after that as far as the episodes I directed. I just enjoyed them all. There's stories to tell from all of them, but another time. All right, Amy in Sydney. Hi, Amy. If your kids asked you what Supernatural was about, what would you say or tell them? I would say, and I have told them, that it is Daddy and Uncle Jared pretending to be funny and goofy and put red paint all over their face. That's what I tell them, because they turn the TV on sometimes, and there we are, bloodied up and fighting, and I'm like, oh yeah, look, there's Daddy and Uncle Jared just playing with those super scary vampires, and that's just paint. They're having a craft party. That's what they're doing. Corinne Lim. Hi, Jensen. What do you think is one of the biggest milestones for you on SBN? Love from Malaysia. That's cool. Biggest milestones on SBN. I don't know. There's been a lot. I'd say just from a character or I guess acting standpoint. I know. I'll go with this. Driving that thing as well as I got. Not saying that I'm the best driver on the planet, but I got pretty good at handling that thing in very kind of tight situations, because I was having to, you'd have to drive in and you'd have to hit a mark, that's this big. The helicopter going over. So to drive in, come at full speed and then stop and hit a mark, I got pretty good at that. So good that a lot of the camera guys, they would take bets on how close I would get to the mark, like 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch. But more importantly, they all felt comfortable with me behind the wheel. And they knew that, they knew I would hit the mark. They knew that I would, have control of the car. Even if it was going full speed, if I was going in reverse, if I was doing some sort of stunt thing with the car, I always felt really comfortable and confident driving that thing, and it's not that's not easy to do when you're surrounded by hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of equipment and people's lives. So I do remember thinking how thankful I was that I was as good driving that thing as I was, because I think it made for a lot of really good shots. And it just made production go that much quicker and that much smoother. So that was certainly something that I will take pride in for a long time.
All right, moving on. Gabby Chloe, did you ever wish you got to film a birthday episode for Dean? Love you. Didn't I? Did we never have Dean's birthday? I feel like we did. I feel like that was something. But we used to have birthdays on our set like every day, because every day somebody was having a birthday and we would always sing happy birthday to them, the whole crew. I might be getting that confused with a Dean birthday, but I kind of feel like we did. And if we didn't, then we certainly should. And then if we seriously never did, then I've got so much cake to catch up on. So, but I'm sure Dean would probably prefer pie. So that's fine. I'm cool with that. All right. Lonnie Martinez. Hi there, Lonnie. Which is your favorite Disney movie? Love from Argentina. Favorite Disney movie. My daughter just asked me that yesterday. She's like, what's your favorite movie? And I'm like, oh, Die Hard. And she's like, no, like cartoons. No, I didn't say Die Hard, but that's a good one. I think I told her kind of the first one that came to my mind that I know I like that I never get tired of watching, and that's Toy Story, the first one. That's just, you know, it's Tom Hanks, and it's a good story, and I liked it. Anyway, we'll go with that for now. Okay, let's see. Noah Ronan 123. How would you react if you found out that monsters and hunters are real? Love you so much. Thank you, Noah. Noah Ronan, you know who you are. Thank you. How would I react? I would probably want to get a good contact. Get some good contact info on my local chapter of hunters. Have them dialed into my favorites, and then I would probably also go out and get some basic supplies. You know, get some salt, some iron, wooden stake, that kind of stuff. Yeah. I don't think I would overreact too much, just simply because I've been dealing with this world for 15 years. So I feel like I would hold it together. But I would certainly want to know the names and the phone numbers of the hunters that had been dealing with it. And then I don't know, maybe I'd say, hey, you got room for one more? I got the car. Last question time. Oh, I missed the song. Where's Benedict when I need him to sing? All right. Last question. Here we go. Valen, Argentina. Hi, Jensen. My name is Valentina. After 15 years of playing Dean, how do you think he changed you in a personal and professional level? In an unimaginable amount. Professional, I think, you know, this is a once in a lifetime opportunity to play a character for this long and to be on a show for this long, and to be able to tell a story that someone truly enjoys and doesn't get tired of, and playing a character that you truly enjoy and never really get tired of. And I could play Dean forever, and probably because I share a lot in common with the guy. So it just feels natural, super natural. No. You know, and from a personal level, like, sure, I've, you know, who I was before I started the show is long gone. It's just as far as like that life that I had. I'm still the same person, but my circumstances have dramatically changed.
And it has afforded me, a life I could have only dreamed of. It has afforded me friends, coworkers, that I will keep in contact with for the rest of my life. And it has introduced me to a fandom that I will forever be grateful for sticking with us and watching us and being as supportive as you guys have been over the years. It truly is a marvel, to not just me, but a lot of those people and a lot of people in the industry. This show is, has always been kind of the show that the little show that could, and it's because of you that we did. So I'm thankful for that. It has forever changed me. So thank you. And that'll do it for me. Guys, I want to thank you for hanging in there, and being safe and appreciating that we can't do these kind of things in person, but we're trying to do the best we can, and give you a little feedback, and please know that we're missing it too. We really miss seeing you guys and being able to show up and see your smiling faces and interact and answer questions in person, and know that when we're able to do that again, we certainly will, because we know we know that this is a unique situation, and we want to preserve it and water it as much as we can. So going into the final week of Supernatural, I really hope you enjoy it. Thank you for being on this ride with us for 15 years. And hopefully one day soon we can see each other in person and talk all about it. Take care, everybody. Bye.
Denson, thank you so much for being here today. Thank you for 15 years of an amazing story, an amazing show, and something that we all love and we can bond over. And we can't wait to see you in the upcoming Boys and everything you do in the future. All right, tipping is now done, and we'll bring you the results of the group meet and greet in just a few moments. But first, make sure you're signed up on our email list through our website, creationent.com, and follow us on social media at creationent on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Hopefully we'll be able to come back with you guys and with live events really soon. We really miss seeing you guys. Okay, the winners of the 10-minute group meet and greet with Jensen is Mimi V, Ashley Carter, Femme Failtale, Megan Lead, and Sunshine Jackals. Once again, that is Mimi V, Ashley Carter, Femme Failtale, Megan Lead, and Sunshine Jackals. You guys, make sure your email address is updated with your current address. If not, hang out in this chat if we have a problem sending you your link. Enjoy your 5-minute 10